Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I welcome you to my video number 202. And today's video is based on instrumental variables and the estimation of two stages least squares. Let me start with the instrumental variables estimation and two stages least squares in econometrics. There is an econometric problem that is called endogeneity, and this is very serious issue while we are modeling econometric equations. And this problem is endemic in social sciences, especially in economics. And why endogeneity occurs? In some cases, important person variables cannot be observed. These variables are often correlated with the observed explanatory variables, and in addition, measurement error may also because of endogeneity. There are certain solutions to endogeneity problem considered so far. Proxy variables method for omitted regression may be used. Fixed effects method can be used if panel data is available, if endogeneity is a time constant, and if regressors are not time constant. Another method is instrumental variables method. Now let me start with the omitted variables in simple regression model. In this regression model, you see that the log of wage is only determined by education, and we exclude experience and experience square from this model. So this is the these two variables are omitted from this model. So this case is known as omitted variables case. Here the error term ui contains factors, for example innate ability, which are correlated with education, and that may create endogeneity issue. So we may use instrumental variable. The definition of instrumental variable entails it does not appear in the regression. It is highly correlated with the endogenous variable, but it is uncorrelated with the error term. Say for example, yi is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 xi plus ui, and we assume that covariance of xi ui is equal to 0. So this xi is basically education, and this is reconstitution of OLS in simple regression model, and this is the original model. A simple consistency proof for OLS under exogeneity. If the covariance between xi and ui is equal to 0, then xi is not endogenous. And this holds as long as the data are such that the sample variances and covariances converge to their theoretical counterparts as n approaches 1. And OLS will be basically consistent if and only if there is exogeneity in the equation. Let us assume the existence of an instrumental variable, zi. Zi is here, and the instrumental variable has a zero covariance with the error term, that is covariance between zi and ui is equal to 0, but covariance of xi and ui is not equal to 0, that is in the original equation. So if we manipulate this, then finally we can use a instrumental variable instead of the education, and the instrumental variable is uncorrelated with the error term, but it is highly correlated with the explanatory variable. Say for example, father education can be taken as instrumental variable for education. If you use OLS and the estimated equation of log of wage is given here. This is the constant and this is the coefficient of the education. So this is return to education, and that is probably overestimated. The sample size is 428, R square is equal to 0.118. Now, if we regress this original education on the father education, then we have this equation, estimated equation. Now, a question is the education of a father a good instrumental variable? Number one, it does not appear as a regressor in this model. Number two, it is significantly correlated with the education because this coefficient is significant. And three, it is uncorrelated with the error term. So, instrumental variable, this equation is log wage, and this is the estimated return to education, which decreases. It is also much less precisely estimated. Other instrumental variables for education that have been used in the literature may be the number of siblings, and they do not determine wage. They are correlated with the education because of resource constraints in the household, and they are uncorrelated with innate ability. Similarly, college proximity when 16 years old can also be taken as an instrumental variable. They are no wage determinant. They are correlated with the education because more education if you live near college, and finally uncorrelated with the error term. So a number of different instrumental variable can be used instead of education, which is endogenous in the OLS model. There are certain properties of instrumental variable with poor instrumental variable. Instrumental variable may be much more inconsistent than OLS if the instrumental variable is not completely exogenous and is weakly related to the original variable xi. So, following this, this is the beta 1 hat in OLS, and that is equal to beta 1 plus the covariance or the correlation between x and u times sigma u divided by sigma x. And this is the beta 1 hat in the instrumental variable case, and here instead of x we have correlation of zu divided by correlation of zx, and this is the quotient sigma u and sigma x. So there is no problem if the instrumental variable is really exogenous. If not, the asymptotic bias will be larger the weaker the correlation with x. Instrumental variable will be worse than OLS if the correlation between ZU divided by correlation between ZX is greater than correlation between Z and U. For example, 0.03 divided by 0.2 is greater than 0.1. Instrumental variable estimation in the multiple regression model. Let us suppose we have this equation y1 is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 y2, beta 2 z1 up to beta k zk minus 1 plus u1. In this case, we assume that y2 is endogenous, while other variables z1 up to zk minus 1 are exogenous variables. Now, condition for instrumental variable are that it does not appear in regression equation, it is uncorrelated with the error term, and is partially correlated with the endogenous explanatory variable. So we may have equation like this, y2 is equal to pi naught plus pi 1 z1 up to pi k zk minus 1 plus pi k zk plus v2, and this is the so called reduced form equation. In regression of the endogenous explanatory variable on all exogenous variables, the instrumental variable must have a non-zero coefficient. Now, what does that mean? Computing instrumental variable estimates in the multiple regressions case, and the first thing is the exogeneity condition. The covariance of Zj with U1 is equal to 0, and j varies from 1 to up to k, as well as expected value of u1 is equal to 0. Use sample analogs of the exogeneity condition, and following these, this yields k plus 1 equations from which the k plus 1 estimates beta naught hat, beta 1 hat up to beta k hat can be obtained. Two stages Lee squares estimation. It turns out that the instrumental variable estimator is equivalent to the following procedure, which has a much more intuitive interpretation. You may follow this. Now, a question is, why does two-stage least squares work? All variables in the second stage regressions are in exogenous because y2 was replaced by a prediction based on only exogenous information. By using the prediction based on exogenous information, y2 is purged of its endogenous part, the part that is related to the error term. So, ladies and gentlemen, the conclusion of this lecture is that if there is endogeneity in the model, we may overcome this problem by introducing a suitable endogenous variable, and then we can rely on the estimation. There are certain properties of two stages least squares. The standard errors from the OLS second stage regression are run. However, it is not difficult to compute correct standard error. If there is one endogenous variable and one instrument, then two stages least square is equal to instrumental variable, and the two stages least square estimation can also be used if there is more than one endogenous variable and at least as many instruments. So, in both cases, two stages least square can be used when there is one endogenous variable and there is one instrumental variable. Similarly, when there are more than one endogenous variables and at least as many instrumental variables, so in that case we can also use two stages least square. This is one example of two stages least square in wage education using two instruments. Here, education is first regressed on experience and experience square, and then father education and mother education, but we see education is significantly partially correlated with education of the parents, and then this two stage least squares estimation results are here. The log of wage is regressed on education, experience and experience square, but this return to education is much lower but also much more imprecise than with the OLS. So, using two stages least squares as a solution to errors in variables problems, if a second measurement of the mismeasured variable is available, this can be used as an instrumental variable for the mismeasured variable. Statistical properties of two stages least square estimation under assumptions completely analogous to OLS, but conditioning on ZI rather than XI, two stages least square is consistent and asymptotically normal. Two stages least square is typically much less precise because there is more multicollinearity and less explanatory variation in the second stage regression. Corrections for heteroscedasticity and serial correlation analogous to OLS, two stages least square easily extends to time series and panel data. Testing for endogeneity can also be done following this method. Ladies and gentlemen, this is how we can use, how we can estimate two stages least square when there is one endogenous or more than one endogenous variable in the model. I hope you have understood the idea of using instrumental variable and dealing with the problem of instrumental variable or endogeneity through the use of instrumental variable. If you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, kindly do subscribe and do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you can get timely notification about my new videos that I will upload for you.